Hi guys, I am Jaya and today I'll talk about optimization of mobile IP and reverse tunneling process in mobile IP. Now let me tell you an ideal situation how we communicate through mobile IP. I'm in India, Indore, my own home agent. And if you are also from Indore and you want to contact me, it's a simple process. The correspondent node will contact my home agent and home agent will send me the message. Now let's complicate the situation. If I'm traveling abroad, say America, and the correspondent node, the person who wants to send me the data packet, also travels abroad to another part of America. Although we are few meters away, but this further complicates the problem since the both correspondent node and mobile node is in another location, that is in foreign agent. So if correspondent node wants to communicate with the mobile node, first of all the correspondent node has to send the message to home agent of the correspondent node, and the home agent of correspondent node further transfers the message or packet to the home agent of the mobile node, and the home agent of mobile node then sends the care of address to the mobile node and along with the message. Now this situation will be further addressed in the PPT. Let's read it out.
In this PowerPoint presentation, the example that I've taken for America has now been changed to Germany and Hawaii. Imagine the following scenario. A Japanese and a German met at a conference on Hawaii. Both want to use their laptops for exchanging data. Both run mobile IP for mobility support. If Japanese sends a packet to the German, his computer sends the data to the home agent of the German, that is from Hawaii to Germany. The home agent in Germany now encapsulates the packets and tunnels them to the care of address of German laptop on Hawaii.
This means that although the computers might be only meters away, the packets have to travel around the world. This inefficient behavior of a non-optimized mobile IP is called triangular routing. The triangle is made of the three segments CN to HA, HA to COA/MN, and MN back to CN. With the basic mobile IP protocol, all packets to the MN have to go through the HA. This can cause unnecessary overheads for the network between CN and HA, but also between HA and COA, depending on the current location of the MN. One way to optimize the route is to inform the CN of the current location of the MN. The CN can learn the location by caching in a binding cache, which is a part of the local routing table for the CN. The appropriate entity to inform the CN of the location is the HA.
We have discussed about the routing issues, that is, the route was not optimized. If both correspondent and mobile node were in foreign agent. Now, to optimize this route, we can use many methods. One of which is that the cache, the binding request that the correspondent node sends, can be stored in a cache, and then that location can be found out by the correspondent node through the table. Now for this route optimization, there are four additional messages that are being sent to optimize the route. These messages are binding request, binding update, binding warning, and binding acknowledgement. Now I'll tell you about these in details in the PowerPoint presentation.
The optimized mobile IP protocol needs four additional messages. Binding request. Any node that wants to know the current location
of an MN can send a binding request to the HA. The HA can check if the MN has allowed dissemination of its current location. If the HA is allowed to reveal the location, it sends back a binding update. Binding update. This message sent by HA to CNs reveal the current location of an MN. The message contains the fixed IP address of the MN and the care of address. The binding update can request an acknowledgement. Binding acknowledgement. If requested, a node returns this acknowledgement after receiving a binding update message. Binding warning. If a node decapsulates a packet for an MN, but it is not the current FA for this MN, this node sends a binding warning. The warning contains MN's home address and a target node address, that is, the address of the node that has tried to send the packet to this MN. Now, let me explain this process to you through a figure. In this figure, first of all, the ideal situation is discussed when both correspondent node and mobile node are in the same home area or home agent. For that, in that case, correspondent node sends a binding request to home agent. Home agent then sends a binding update to the correspondent node. The correspondent node further sends an acknowledgement to the home agent. And then the data is sent to the mobile node. But when mobile node changes its location, in that case,
MN registers with new foreign agent, and then new foreign agent sends an update request to old foreign agent, and old foreign agent sends acknowledgement to new foreign agent. Then the correspondent node sends the data to the mobile node. But if old foreign agent sends a binding warning to home agent, then the home agent sends an update request to correspondent node, and correspondent node sends acknowledgement to home agent, and then the correspondent node sends in the data to the mobile node.
In the presentation, it was being discussed about what is triangular routing problem, how to resolve that problem, how to optimize the route of mobile IP. Now, there are certain problems associated with triangular routing. Now, these are namely time to live, that is TTL, multicasting, and firewall. See, if a person is in foreign area or in foreign agent, so there are firewalls that debars a person from communicating directly to the correspondent node or the correspondent node to communicate with the mobile node. So firewalls act as a problem in case of triangular routing problem. Now, second is multicasting. What if you wanted to do a conference call, that is to a multicast group? Now, this is a situation which triangular routing problem cannot solve. And thirdly, it is TTL, time to live. Now, if mobile nodes want to communicate with each other in foreign agent, so there are different TTLs for home areas and foreign areas. So these TTL keeps on changing. But if we use the process of reverse tunneling, there is only one hop through which the communication is possible. So triangular routing problem poses us with different issues like TTL, multicasting, and firewalls. Now, the solution to these problems is reverse tunneling process, which I'm going to further explain it to you.
Now, reverse tunneling process involves three simple steps. The first step is mobile node communicates with the foreign agent. The foreign agent tunnels and encapsulates the packet and sends it to home agent. The home agent further sends the packet to the receiver. Now, this reverse tunneling process will be easy to understand through this image.
Here in the figure, MN sends to FA, FA tunnels packets to HA by encapsulation, HA forwards the packet to the receiver. At first glance, the return path from the MN to the CN shown in figure looks quite simple. The MN can directly send its packets to the CN as in any other standard IP situation. The destination address in the packets is that of CN. But there are several severe problems associated with this simple solution, such as firewall, TTL, and multicasting explained previously. Obviously, reverse tunneling now creates a triangular routing problem in the reverse direction. All packets from an MN to a CN go through the HA. RFC 3024 does not offer a solution for this reverse triangular routing because it is not clear if the CN can decapsulate packets. Remember that mobile IP should work together with all traditional non-mobile IP nodes. Therefore, one cannot assume that a CN is able to be a tunnel endpoint.
We have read about the process of reverse tunneling and how it solves the problem of triangular routing. Now, reverse tunneling also has shortcomings of its own. The first shortcoming being it abuses or tries or circumvents the firewall. Now, one should not bypass the firewall. So in this situation, reverse tunneling poses a security threat. Now, second is reverse tunneling also creates the problem of reverse triangular routing. If we were to send the packet from correspondent node to the mobile node, so this problem of reverse triangular routing has not yet been addressed by the reverse tunneling process.
Reverse tunneling does not solve all problems with firewalls. The reverse tunnel can be abused to circumvent security mechanisms, tunnel hijacking. Optimization of data path, that is, packets will be forwarded through the tunnel via the HA to a sender, longer routes. The new standard is backwards compatible. The extensions can be implemented easily.
So guys, this was about optimization in mobile IP and the process of reverse tunneling. Now, if you want to download my PowerPoint presentation, its link is given in the description. And to know more about mobile IP and encapsulation and registration process of mobile IP, you can also check out the video link given below.